everybody. So every week, or every month, I wish, but every month I get a subscription service called Retro Game Treasure. And basically, what it is they send you, you make a list of the game, high kind of games you like, the consoles you have, stuff like that, and they, every month, send you a box of retro games, or random retro games, that fit that description. And they do this really great thing where they let you put in what games you own already so that you don't have to worry about repeats. Awesome. It's really awesome. But basically, I figured since getting these is a huge factor in me starting streaming, I figured, hey, why not? Why not take a look and open some of these for you? So let's take a look. So I'll start with the one I got 2 months ago. This one I have already opened. I already know what's inside. I think I actually took one of the games out. I'm not sure what it was. So we'll just see what's still in here. So we'll start with the thing I was most excited to see. Complete box copy of Monster Hunter Portable 2G for the PSP. Now it is the best like hits variant of the cover, which is kind of ugly and gross looking. The other thing, and it comes with the full manual inside, which is cool, and you know the little UMD, which is cool. Now I'm not a huge Monster Hunter fan. I might take a look at it. The other thing is I don't know any Japanese, so probably not going to really examine that too much. But on top of that, I also got Final Fantasy 12 Revenant Wings, if that focuses, yeah, which is a DS, I think, action RPG that runs on the DS that's in the Final Fantasy 12 like canon. Pretty cool. Maybe we'll get to that at some point if there's ever an easy solution for getting a video out of the DS. Because all of the mods that did it are no longer in production. So, yeah, it sucks. And then on top of that, we've also got Yu-Gi-Oh! The Ultimate Masters, the tournament, World Championship Tournament 2006. For the Game Boy Advance. Another game, maybe we'll see it on a Random Game Fridays, but we'll have to see. But for right now, this is going in the box because I don't know if I'll... It's nice to have. I like having it in the collection. I don't know how much I'll play it, but maybe we'll touch it on a Random Game Fridays coming up. So that's 2 months ago, and then this month. This came early last week, late last week, something like that. Cut it open already, so let's take a look at what we got. Cool. We've got an N64 transfer pack, which is actually something I've wanted. I don't have one. Awesome. It's only really used for 3 games. I think it lets you use your Pokemon from Red and Blue, and maybe Gold and Silver and Yellow in Pokemon Stadium 1 and 2, but also it lets you play them on the N64 through like an emulator in the game. That's pretty cool. And I think it also lets you use your player characters from the Game Boy Color copy or version of Mario Tennis on the N64 version of Mario Tennis with like all of their upgraded abilities and stuff, because that game's an RPG and I didn't know that. But yeah, so it's cool. It's nice to have. It's not super useful. I didn't have one though, so that's useful. That's nice. I've got a Famicom game. Not sure what it is. It's 1986, as you can see there at the bottom. 1986 Bandai game. Can't read Japanese. I wish there was an easy way to, like, figure these out. See if there's like a quick Famicom art. Famicom cart like identifier. Super useful. useful. All right, well, I'll have to look it up, and then I will, I'll let you guys know in a future stream what it is. But yeah, it's a Famicom. It's a Famicom NES game. It's a Famicom game from Bandai. So we'll have to keep it in mind for a future retro game for Random Game Fridays when I do Famicom. I'll do a bunch of Famicom games in a row because I have probably four or five of them now because of Retro Game Treasure, which is cool. Ah, yes, the infamously bad Crash Purple for the Game Boy Advance. Ripto's Rampage. So there was a weird crossover game between Crash and Spyro on the Game Boy Advance, and Spyro's was Spyro Orange or something. But basically, they like crossed over, and it was bad though. It wasn't good at all. Maybe we'll take a look at it and just experience it. But there's been a couple YouTubers that have done like reviews on the game. I know Ant Dude's done one. People have reviewed it. It's not good. I've never played it, so maybe we'll experience it together. I don't know. We'll keep it in mind. Ah, cool. So we've got Kingdom Hearts 358 Days Over 2. So this is my fault. I own this game already. I'm really bad about when I go out and pick up my own games. I don't go in and update my game list. Now the nice thing is if they send you something, they update it for you about a week later so you can still be a surprise. You can't log in and see what they sent you. But I am really bad about it. I have a whole bunch. I have like 20 some games that I've bought, maybe even more, probably closer to 50, that I've bought and haven't gone back and updated the list. I need to do it. I keep pushing it off. I need to remember to do it. But yeah, so that's a fun game. I've actually played it through all the way, and it gets a bad rap. People complain that it's confusing. I mean, it is a little confusing. But that is the complaint a lot of people have for the Kingdom Hearts story as a whole. And honestly, if you put any amount of effort in to understanding it, it's not that hard. It's just they don't spoon feed you every detail. But then on top of that, they say it's repetitive, it's long and boring. However, I think the repetitiveness of it comes from it being a mission-based thing. So every day there's a new mission. You go out and do a new mission. Which is actually a really good mechanic idea when you're playing like a portable game, right? Because you don't know how you want to play that in short bursts. And so it works really well. And honestly, it's super impressive how good it looks and how well it runs for a DS game. There's some simplification of systems. Some of the combat's a little bit simpler, but overall, it is a full-blown Kingdom Hearts game on the DS. That is pretty insane. I think it's pretty impressive for what it is. I like it. You know, give it a try if you have a chance. You probably won't see it streamed anytime soon, because playing DS games and getting video out is pretty much impossible right now, because the people making the mods that let you do it don't do it anymore. So that's a little frustrating. Ah, yes. So, this is pretty cool. And it's sealed. Wow. So it's a sealed copy of Fat Princess Fistful of Cake. Now, I've never played any of these games. I think there's a couple of them, but I've never played them. This looks like it's from Canada, as well. Because it's got French and English on it. But yeah, it's sealed. We'll go ahead and open it real quick. I am going to try and play it at some point. Because PSP has video out. Looking at you, Nintendo. I mean, I can't even say that because Sony didn't put video out on the Vita. So I can't even complain all that much. But the PSP has video out. I don't have the cable for it. But I have a couple Vita games that I think would be fun to sit down and play on stream. But yeah, so Fat Princess Fistful of Cake. We've got a nice color manual, and we got the UMD in here. Nice. Yeah, so I'm not even sure what type of game this is. Is it like a... I'm not even sure what type of game this is, but it looks like it's fun. So, you know, it'll go on the pile of things to do. But anyway, that's it for this month, which is like 2 months combined, of my retro game treasure. It's a service that I really like. You'll have to check it out if you're interested. RetroGameTreasure.com. I'll make sure I put some information down in the description on YouTube. But yeah, like I said,